morning, boys and girls. Happy Children's Day. On this special day, I am pleased to bring to you our special guest and have a special interview with him. The theme of this year's Children's Day is Born to Shine. We aim to inspire our children about taking leadership by making an impact to the community. Here with us today, the leader of our school, the president director, as well as the founder of Bina Bangsa School, Bapak Surya Putra Subandi. We are going to get to know him more closely, and I have some questions to ask him.
Hello.
Hello, Pak Surya. Thank you very much for joining us today in Peak Primary. You want to say something to our children first?
Happy Children's Day for all the children, for all the Bina Bangsa School children.
Thank you so much, Pak Surya. It is not always every year that we get this greeting from our President Director. Okay, Pak Surya, I have some questions for you. I would like to know what inspired you to do what you do, to set up a school and run a school, Bina Bangsa School. Apa yang menginspirasi Bapak untuk memulai dan membangun sekolah?
Ini kembali kita flashback ke tahun 98. Setelah peristiwa 98, kawan-kawan yang seumuran saya saat itu, anak-anaknya semua masih di anak sekolah SD, SMP, SMA. Demi menyelamatkan keluarga mereka, mengirim mereka ke luar, ke Singapura, Malaysia, ke Australia. Tapi setelah semua kembali tenang, mereka mulai merasa gelisah. Bagaimana anak-anaknya bisa kembali ke Indonesia? Sekolah di tengah jalan tidak diterima. Tapi kalau lanjutkan di luar negeri sana, mereka akan menemukan kesulitan-kesulitan seperti kondisi ekonomi, kondisi keakraban, kekeluargaan. Itu semua yang jadi sangat penting untuk saya mempertimbangkan saat itu. Maka saya memberanikan diri, saya sharing dengan mereka. Bagaimana kalau saya mempunyai ide sekolahan Singapura dipindahkan ke Indonesia? Yaitu kita siapkan gedung sekolah, tapi pengajarnya, kurikulumnya dari Singapura. Kenapa saya memilih Singapura? Sebab satu, mereka adalah di bawah Cambridge. Ijazahnya berlaku di seluruh dunia. Dari segi kurikulum sudah memenuhi syarat sebagai sekolah internasional. Tetapi kita masih mempertahankan sebagai bangsa timur adalah yang terpenting adalah culture. Bagaimana menghormati orang tua. Itu yang saya selalu mempertimbangkan, itu bedanya kita dengan di barat. Saya khawatir sekali anak-anak yang sudah keluar negeri sudah tidak dekat lagi dengan orang tua. Itulah tujuan saya saat itu. Ya, ingin sekali membuka sekolahan Bina Bangsa School.
Okay, so it is a very good testimony. What we can see here is that Pak Surya continue to see the gap between among the needs of the family during that time. The need to have quality of education, but also another important need, which is to keep the family together, and you bring these two together and come up with the idea of setting up a school like our school as of today, Bina Bangsa School. So indeed, it is really come from not only your ambition, but it is from knowing the needs of the people around you, the families, your friends, and how you can accommodate to their needs as well. Oh, that is very honorable, Bapak Surya. Well, talking about Singapore, talking about Western, just now you also mentioned, and I sometimes heard you mentioning bringing the food from West and East. What do you mean by that? Can you explore more? Pak pernah dan sering mengatakan bahwa bawa yang baik dari luar, tapi bawa juga pertahankan yang ada di timur. Apa maksud pernyataan Pak?
Ya, itu yang tadi di mula-mula saya sudah bicarakan tujuan kita membuka sekolah bunga bangsa ya. Bagaimanapun kita akui dari segi teknologi adalah negara barat memimpin. Jadi kita inginkan anak-anak kita mendapatkan pendidikan yang termaju di dunia. Bisa mengikuti kemajuan-kemajuan di dunia ini. Tetapi di samping itu tidak melupai culture ketimuran kita. Untuk selalu mendekat dengan orang tua. Kita harus mengingati bahwa kita culture timur beda sekali dengan barat. Teknologi boleh ikuti barat, tapi culture tetap mempertahankan ketimuran kita. Itu yang saya tujukan.
Bapak mungkin bisa juga cerita what has been maybe I think you are facing a lot of challenges ya along the way. What has been one of your biggest challenges as a leader? Apa satu tantangan terbesar Bapak sebagai seorang pemimpin dalam konteks pemimpin?
Ini kalau bagi saya selalu isi going aja ya. Kita hadapi kesulitan, ternyata kita semuanya serahkan kepada Tuhan Yang Maha Kuasa. Kita hanya bertindak sesuai hati nurani kita saja. Apa yang kita akan laksanakan. Berhasil atau tidaknya pandangan-pandangan kita tetap serahkan kepada Yang Maha Kuasa. Banyak sekali contoh-contoh yang kita tidak bisa dengan panjang lebar cerita di sini kemujizatan-kemujizatan Bina Bangsa 10 saat kita baru mulai buka. Itu sangat seperti cerita, seperti dongeng, tapi itu real kenyataannya terjadi semua di diri saya.
So you are saying that a lot of challenges, okay, yes. You cannot mention them one by one.
Yeah.
And not only that you pass the challenges, but sometimes you experience miracles. Something that you didn't know what to do, but it has a solution, yeah. And you know that God is behind.
Yeah.
Alright. Bapak Surya, I have another question for you. Why is school? I know you are a businessman. You run a number of business. Why is it that you choose education? Kenapa Bapak memilih pendidikan?
Itu mungkin daya tarik dari saya kecil ya, apa yang saya bicarakan, kakek saya sudah buka sekolahan. Dari keluarga papa saya also a math teacher.
Your father is a math teacher?
Yes.
That is why you like mathematics?
Yes. Yeah. My uncle also is a economic dosen in China University.
Oh, a lecturer in China University.
Yes. So, all my father family is a teacher or like dosen. Mm. So maybe when I child, I still said my father teach me how to learn Mathematica very easily. Because my father also graduated from Cambridge for Mathematica. So when he teaching me, I feel how to say enjoy.
Okay.
Enjoy.
Tadi Bapak sebutkan bahwa kakek punya sekolah.
Iya.
Your grandfather had a school. Bagaimana lanjutan sekolah?
Saat 50-an kakek saya boleh dikatakan salah satu the success businessman in Jakarta. Saat itu dia sudah ada minat ingin membuka sekolahan karena papa saya pun guru matematika. Jadi saat papa dan mama menikah, dia membuat pengumuman yang besar, tidak terima kado berupa bunga dan barang, hanya menerima cash untuk membangun sekolahan di lahan yang dia telah miliki. Maka jadilah sekolahan saat itu sekolahan Mingfa Chinese School, jadi Menteng, di Menteng ada Chinese School. Sampai tahun 66 disita pemerintah, ya dengan lahannya pun hilang semua itu.
So maybe that is one thing you want to continue your what your grandpa has established before.
For my father, it's the different case. When the government closed the Chinese school, 66, my father told me, if you have a golden chance to open again the school, please open the school.
So that is, I think, one of the reasons also.
Not only one of the reasons, maybe so many reasons for me. Mm-hmm. When I studied at primary school, I am a good boy, a good student. Mm-hmm. Maybe at that time, the Chinese school more disciplined than now. Mm-hmm. Straight like that. If you get out to say, angka yang jelek di kelas, bisa memalukan grup kita satu baris itu. Sebab dia tiap baris dipertandingkan. Umpama matematika saya paling jago, saya akan ajari kawan-kawan satu baris saya, jangan sampai kalah. Begitu pula kimia yang saya paling benci, kawan kita yang jago di fisika, di kimia akan mengajari kita, jangan sampai tertinggal. Maka saat itu rata-rata angka-angka sekolah yang Chinese itu tinggi-tinggi semua.
Okay.
Ini bisa dibuktikan saat tahun 67 kita pindah ke sekolah nasional, angka matematika, fisika itu pasti kita yang kuasai semua. Itu yang saya di memori saya. Tapi setelah SMP saya change the situation, semuanya membuat saya frustrasi. Karena bahasa nomor satu kita tidak begitu jelas. Penjelasan, cara teknik mengajar pun berbeda. Jadi saya frustrasi. Terlebih-lebih di SMA, semua gampang digunakan dengan uang. Bisa beli ini, bisa angka, semua bisa dibeli. Kita kalau mau ujian apa, kita tinggal samperin ke teachernya, kasih uang, dia akan kasih angka. Tapi kita senang saat itu. Saat itu kita yes, senang. Tapi after that kita menyesal. Menyesal sampai membawa di hati saya, suatu saat saya akan buka sekolahan. Apa yang dinamakan sekolahan itu? Sesuai dengan petunjuk papa saya dulu mengalaminya di sekolahan papa saya itu. Maka mulai 2001 ada golden chance buat kita tidak sia-siakan kesempatan itu. Mungkin sedikit flashback. Di tahun 2001, saya adalah presiden director memiliki bank keluarga. Dan saat itu saya fit and proper test sudah lulus di BI. Keluarga minta saya menduduki posisi preskom di bank. Tapi saya tolak, saya tidak mau, saya bilang, saya lebih baik di sekolahan di Nabang tersebut. Saya tidak akan in charge di perbankan. Dan, tapi tidak ada satupun keluarga kita yang insan di perbankan. Maka saya janjikan Senobia anak saya sekolah di Singapura untuk ambil banking and finance. Tapi ternyata tidak digunakan. Senobia sama hobinya seperti saya, ingin terjun di sekolahan. Jadi dia lanjutkan lagi di London, ambil early childhood-nya.
That is a very nice sharing, Mokasulia. Yeah. From the story that you share, it seems that the hardship you don't give up, although the school may not be fun all the time, a very strict school when you were in primary school, but it turns out to be something good where you can work with your classmates, helping one another.
Yes.
I think that is the value that the children here can learn from. Also, you shared just now about how you, the sacrifice that you made, although you have many options, and then some of the options are more attractive, more maybe from the world, positions in the bank, the highest positions.
Yeah.
But you follow your heart. Mm-hmm. You see that choosing or setting up a school, choosing education is more valuable to you, and therefore you pursue that, although maybe with greater risks than the other options that you have in mind. So thank you so much for sharing that kind of testimony. I hope these things really inspire the students about about running the life, making choices in lives, and how we continue to use the resources, the talent, the passions that we have in our lives for the goodness of other people. And you also, Pak Surya also mentioned a lot about the value of family, how his grandfather, his father continued to inspire him in whatever he is doing right now. And I think his message is very clear, children, respect your parents, because they are the source of your aspirations, and they can be the source of the channel through which God may tell you his great plan for you. Okay, Pak Surya, because today is Children's Day, therefore we have here with us one of the children in UBS Peak Primary, Henry Kusuma Tanjama from P3 Respect. He is here with us today through Zoom, and he will have a short interview with you.
Okay.
Hi, Bapak Surya.
Hello, good morning.
How are you?
Fine. How about you, Henry?
And I'm 7 years old. Nice to meet you.
Yeah.
I have a lot of questions here in my note. Would you help me answer them?
Yeah, I do my best to answer you.
Okay, So the first question is, what do you do as the president director of Bina Bangsa School?
I go to meeting and I think a lot about the future plan of BBS. Also about all the student future.
That's good.
Yes.
Is your job hard?
No, but challenging. And I enjoy myself.
Interesting.
Yes.
Is there something fun in your job?
Of course, it's fun to see, like you, from preschool. Suddenly, when we meet again, I saw you already taller than me, and already graduated from JC.
That's really, really good. Yeah. Amazing. What was the scariest moment in your life?
Yeah, maybe in my life once. At that time, when we was a Brisbane, kita naik roller coaster, Dobidoo. I never before. Nah, only like kirain cuma lihat hantu-hantu. Tahu-tahunya itu adalah roller coaster.
That's really, really, really scary.
Yes.
What was your favorite subject in school?
My favorite subject is math and basketball.
That's also my favorite subject. Basketball is my favorite sport. Yeah. And math is my favorite school subject.
Yeah. Okay.
Nice.
Okay. Okay.
And by the way, how was primary school like at your time?
When primary school at that time, I'm a clever boy.
Clever.
Yes, I am a clever boy.
That's really, really smart.
Yeah.
And good.
But after that,
this is never good.
Yeah. Okay.
The next question is the fun one. Do you like jokes and riddles?
I like jokes.
Good. Okay, I'll give you the easiest one. What do you call a snail on a ship? It starts with S.
Maybe. I'm old now, so I can't understand about your job now. I will answer you job after this. For presentation, I can answer, but now I cannot answer. Yeah, okay, it's okay. The important is the result.
Reveal the answer. What time are those for? We don't have any time. Do you have any more time for jokes?
One more. Okay.
Why was 6 afraid of 7? Because 7, 8, 9. Get it? 7 is eating, 9 and 8 is just eating. So that's why 6 is afraid of 7. Get it?
I will answer the right answer after this.
Okay.
Not now. Okay.
Thank you for chatting with me, Papa Surya. See you around.
Yeah, thank you.
Send my regards to for your parents, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
Pak Surya, terakhir, ada tak pesan atau nasihat untuk anak-anak SD yang hari ini melihat interview ini dan juga merayakan Children's Day? What advice can you give to these children during this Children's Day?
Advice saya hanyalah nikmatilah kekanak-kanakan kalian. Take it easy aja, jangan menganggap tuh sekolah adalah suatu beban. Terlebih-lebih setelah 2 tahun tidak ketemu kawan-kawan. Sebaiknya kita pun mendambakan bisa kumpul kembali. Ini waktu yang sangat sulit. Boleh dikatakan seumur hidup saya pun tidak pernah mengalami keadaan sekarang ini 2 tahun tidak itu. Jadi saya hanya inginkan anak-anak jangan menjadikan beban. Tidak perlu is number one atau number two di sekolahan. Tapi minimal harus menguasai materi yang sudah dikasihkan kepada anak-anak oleh guru-guru. Jadi minimal tidak tertinggal lah, itu basicnya, itu aja. Tapi jangan terlalu beban. Kalau beban itu anak membahayakan sekali bagi anak-anak ya. Lebih baik lepas saja, santai saja.
Baik, okay. Thank you Pak Surya for your time. Dear boys and girls, Pak Surya has been a great example of his vision in education and how he channels his talents and resources that God has given to him to bring quality education in Indonesia by establishing Bina Bangsa School. I hope that his leadership, his life testimony will inspire you too to shine as a leader in the future with the passion and interest and talents that God has given you. Happy Children's Day. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.